Hello, I am Count Zero, and this is my Let's Play of Mass Effect 3. You're not seeing me on camera this time, because I'm not streaming. Not just not using the on-camera overlay, but just not streaming this time, because it had some technical difficulties last time. Anywho, this time we are returning to Eden Prime. Rifle. Go down. So that should compensate for the reduced damage somewhat. The weight decrease, which should increase her power recharge time, which is a big deal because that's her kind of her whole thing. One point, which I can't put into anything. 2 points, which I can't put anything. 4 points, I can upgrade. Spend it all on your boosting grenade radius. Some of this opening cutscene we covered last time. We're kind of retreading it this time as a refresher.
Eden Prime. This is where it all began.
Yep.
Where the Prothean beacon gave you the vision that warned us about the Reapers.
And where you went up against Saren and the Geth for the first time, no?
Yes. And now, with Cerberus here, Eden Prime's colonists are under attack again. They deserve better. I know. The Alliance did what it could to evacuate colonists, but Cerberus came in so quickly.
Our forces are stretched so thin.
If we find survivors, we'll do what we can. What about this artifact? Is it part of the Prothean device we found on Mars?
The Alliance didn't get any specifics about what Cerberus has uncovered. But whatever it is, it's better off with us than with Cerberus.
I'm bringing you in as close to the dig site as I can. No way we'll avoid detection, but you should have a few minutes.
Understood. All right, everyone. Get ready to move.
With luck, we can get to the dig site before Cerberus knows we're here.
I'm clipping there with the gun.
No sign of survivors. Come on, we need to find the dig site.
This was a beautiful colony once.
They came back after the Geth attack. They'll come back from this.
They rebuilt Mendoir. It wasn't the same.
They'll never forget. All we can hope is that they grow stronger for it.
Anyone here? For med kits right now. I just up anyway. I worry about bringing with them handing you so much ammo this fast. Oh, that's not good.
Shepard, this Cerberus data could help the colonists still alive on other parts of Eden Prime.
How?
I can get this intel to Eden Prime's resistance. Maybe it will help them fight back against
that
Cerberus.
That would be really helpful. I'd say, like, yeah. Just let them know the truth that captured colonists are being taken and used. Slave labor getting turned into their dated super soldier things. Way too quiet.
There. That's the elevator that leads down into the dig site.
Okay. You've got the other shoe to drop any second now.
Goddess, that doesn't seem possible. It's not a Prothean artifact, it's... a Prothean.
You mean a collector? Those things the Reapers turn the Protheans into?
No. An original, unmodified Prothean who's still alive.
You're right. That doesn't sound possible.
You saw Prothean stasis chambers in the archives on Ilos. The only reason those failed was a lack of power. Cerberus found this in an underground bunker. It still has power. He's been in stasis for the past 50,000 years, waiting for us. Think of what we could learn.
Hopefully they could help.
Good thing we brought our Prothean expert.
I hope I can help. If this single Prothean was sent into stasis, he could be the foremost scientist of his time, or perhaps the wisest counselor. Cerberus damaged the life pod when they excavated it. The life signs are unstable.
Then let's get him out of there.
No, breaking open the pod would kill him. We have to find the command signal that ends the stasis mode. We also need to figure out how to physically open the pod without doing more damage. Cerberus took over the labs nearby to research what they found at the dig site. That's likely our best bet.
Heads up!
Oh boy. Alright, quick reminder. Alright, weapon wheel is LB. Oh hey, you have sniper rifles, so do I. Come on, say hi.
All right, let's get moving before more of them come back.
That's why I like playing sniper rifle. Why is the mapped bullet time power? Oh. Here. Ah. Cash, but not really. Thank you.
When humanity won a position on the council for its part in defending the citadel.
Book refresher on Eden Prime. Events of the first game. And the Prothean Beacon. So Nemesis, that is Service Sniper. Sanctum. That's in the planet's ice. Scanned over last time, I believe. Oh, and we don't have a map yet. Down that way. Refresher grenades. All right. Grenades. Melee. Alt. There you go. Come on, say hi. Thank you. taking turrets. That's you.
I'm on it.
That's the last one. Stock on medkit, because I actually used some this time. I could theoretically gone up and over, provided more cover and a sniping position that way.
There. That lab found footage of the Protheans.
Okay. All right, let's see what we got. This is the SimStim thing that I saw. This is the SimStim thing as I read about the codex earlier. It looks like I didn't find a Prothean scientist.
How many have we lost?
Reaper forces have destroyed approximately 300,000 life pods.
I can duplicate that to open the life pod.
You understood that?
You didn't?
No. All I saw was static. Cerberus was trying to make sense of it without success. The Prothean cipher you received on Pharos, it lets you see the images as a Prothean would and understand their language.
Whatever it does, I saw the video and how they sealed the life pods.
Perfect. Then we just need the signal they use to activate stasis mode.
I am willing to bet that the Prothean I'm going to find is less a Prothean scientist or what have you, or the Prothean equivalent of So, Do you have the Prothean version of me as a renegade? Or Paragon?
They were gunned down while having drinks and watching the game.
Son of a bitch, this was somebody's home.
Oh, I freaking hate those things. What else is left?
Found footage of the Protheans. Cerberus is studying it to find the stasis deactivation signal.
Anything else over here? Salvage. Okay. I presume this is meant to sort of buffer the loading for a cutscene that'll come up after this.
Sacrifice will be honored in the coming empire.
I mean, there isn't any time to wait for them, really.
got the signal the Protheans used to activate stasis mode.
Well then, back to the pod.
Backup forces are here.
Mind not moving in front of me, please. You mind? What the hell? You knocked me forward into a bunch of enemies who then beat the crap out of me. Okay. Hit the wrong button there. I wanted to hit resume. I should have hit... Oh well, that's fine. Go through that door and end up taking on the guy's head on. And you don't want to rush a turret head on, because that's just bad. Alright.
Yeah. I've got the signal the Protheans used to activate stasis mode.
To move over here.
Oh,
Okay. All right. There we go. And closer save. Go straight that way. We're gonna go this way and try to flank them. Mail slot right there. There we go. Thank you very much. This way I can flank them. Sniper rifle, hopefully. In the turret. Oh! There we go. Some more ammo now. Much better. In the ass fight.
They've retracted the bridge. We have to find another way across.
Okay. Well. That's not good.
We find the better chance yep. They'll have.
Can't go that way. Like I have to head descend down this way. Round? No, that's not it. So I've been that way before. Over this way? Nope. Back to the pod. See if in the area around the pod there'll be some sort of clue as far as where I need to go. Look around, see what we got. Aha, go this way. Over here. Elevator. Oh, ladder. And then over to the pod.
I'm transmitting the signal.
And while it's processing it, we're going to get attacked by more enemies.
Lots of bogeys inbound, Commander. We'll have to hold this position.
Sorry. Ah, crap. How far back did I go? engineer with stasis.
Got a second to catch
okay.
Breath.
Wish my corner man was here. I could use an ice pack.
Has the life pod ended stasis mode?
If anybody's low, there's a Cerberus supply cache in the building next door.
I can lay down a singularity to block enemy access.
Okay, so I'm toast here. Yep. What I need to do is for the next wave, I need to stay inside, get outdoors and stay inside, because then I'm more fortified, a bit more protection.
Heavy mech, don't let it get close.
Alright, so go look at Lift's armor. Weaken that using a warp. There we go. There's a big stompy robot. Oh, come on. Alright. Much better.
May take him some time to fully regain consciousness.
And wake up right now.
Careful, he's confused.
Oh crap, and I'm in no condition to fight him right now.
Remember, it's been 50,000 years for us, but for him, it's only been...
a few minutes!
No, the bunker is falling. There is no other option.
There are pods online! Those soldiers are still alive!
Their sacrifice will be honored in the coming Empire. Preparing neutron bombardment. Get to your life pod now.
Yep, this is the Prothean me. It sucks to be him.
How many others?
Just you. You can understand me?
Yes. Now that I have read your physiology, your nervous system, enough to understand your language.
So you were reading me while I was seeing...
our last moments. Our failure.
Your people did everything they could. And never give up. And I could use some of that commitment now.
Shepard, whatever you did got Cerberus interested.
Asari. Human. I'm surrounded by primitives.
It's not safe here. Will you join us?
You fight the Reapers?
Yes.
Then we will see.
Yeah, he's got to work on picking up some of our idioms. Protein. Well, then next time we will do our next. Okay, let's wait till we get aboard the ship.
A living Prothean.
That's correct, Admiral. But he's not quite what we expected.
Commander, our scientists barely understand what they need to do here. If the Prothean can help us construct this device, we need his cooperation.
Understood, Admiral.
We're losing colonies faster than we can evacuate. We've never seen a force like the Reapers.
He has, Admiral.
Can he help us?
I intend to find out.
Good. Cerberus slipped up and gave us a new weapon. Don't let it go to waste. Hack it out.
Shepard, I need you down in the port cargo hold. It's about our new guest.
I'm on my way.
He's probably not happy, and he's probably not getting along well with the crew.
What's the problem?
I've tried to make the room more accommodating, but they're not letting me talk to him.
Apologies, Doctor. Contact protocol with a new species. Assume hostility. We had to dust off the regulations.
But he's not new. I've spent my life studying Protheans.
At ease. I don't think our guest will be a problem.
We need him just as much as he needs us.
Will he?
That depends on you. I can sense fear in you. Anxiety and distress. The Reapers are winning.
What do you mean, you sense?
All life provides clues for those who can read them. It is in your cells, your DNA. Experience is a biological marker.
Then what exactly did I experience back on Eden Prime? That was a hell of a flashback.
The battle left its own mark on me. I communicated this to you. It can work both ways.
Like your beacons.
Yes. Which?
Which I'd contacted previously.
You found one. You saw it all. Our destruction. Our warnings. Why weren't they heeded? Why didn't you prepare for the Reapers, human?
It's Commander. And nobody could understand your warnings. The beacon nearly killed me.
Then communication is still primitive in this cycle.
We pieced together what we could, and used it to stop a Reaper invasion 3 years ago.
Then the extinction was delayed.
Now we have your plans for the device. We're going to build it.
Device?
The weapon your people were working on. I'd hoped you could tell us how to finish it.
We never finished it. It was too late.
Then I take it you don't know anything about the catalyst.
No. I was a soldier, not a scientist. Skilled in one art, killing.
What was your mission?
Among my people, there were avatars of many traits. Bravery, strength, cunning, a single exemplar for each.
Which are you?
The embodiment of vengeance. I am the anger of a dead people, demanding blood be spilled for the blood we lost. Only when the last Reaper has been destroyed will my purpose be fulfilled. I have no other reason to exist.
That's coming.
Those who share my purpose become allies. Those who do not become casualties.
A bit much.
Nothing in our fight against the Reapers has been that cut and dried.
Because you still have hope that this war will end with your honor intact.
I do.
Stand in the ashes of a trillion dead souls and ask the ghosts if honor matters. This silence is your answer.
We found this at the dig site. I assume it belongs to you.
It is a memory shard.
Could it help us with the device?
No. It contains only pain. But I will help you fight. And the last thing the Reapers hear before they die will be the last voice of the Protheans, sending them to their grave.
If you don't mind, I have a few more questions I'd like to ask.
Here it comes.
Hey.
I've written over a dozen studies on your species. I've published in several journals that...
Oh, snap.
Asari have finally mastered writing.
I'm sorry?
Never mind. What do you wish to do?
Okay.
We've never seen a species with this sensory ability you have.
It was common among my people. Imparting experience through touch, the chemistry.
Get this exposition.
Complicated ideas could be absorbed in seconds.
That sounds very useful.
We evolved as hunters. Reading 1,000 details in our environment ensured our survival.
Get through this interview here before I can.
Beginning to understand the beacons a bit more.
Wrap up this episode.
Later, we developed technology to harness our ability. Information could be stored in certain objects through touch. Memory has its own biomarker, its own chemistry, as do knowledge and skills. The beacons could remember these things.
Things like Reaper invasions.
Yes, I can still sense the turmoil in you, witnessing the extinction of our empire. The fabric of your being was forever marked that day.
So, could you read something about this room?
There was liquid, a form of incubation, the DNA of a Krogan who lived here. He was powerful, prone to violence.
I'm impressed. His name was Grunt.
And if he were my enemy, I would have given him a wide berth. There is great strength in his genes.
What can you tell us about your own war with the Reapers?
Many of the details were lost. The conflict lasted for centuries. Those that faced the Reapers in the beginning were long dead when I was born. There were memory shards, however, passed down from soldier to soldier. They gave us fragments of what happened.
Several years ago, we found a Prothean VI that called itself Vigil on the planet Ilos. He was the caretaker of a research project.
During my life, Ilos was only a rumor. It was said we had cities there. Built on the ruins of a civilization before us, the Inusanon.
Interesting.
Our scientists did have a research facility. Whatever they were doing was secret.
Yes, Vigil said they wiped all traces of themselves from the records so the Reapers couldn't find them.
The scientists eventually went into cryogenic stasis.
More of my people survived?
No, but they did stop the Reapers from taking control of the Citadel in this cycle. It delayed their invasion.
I never saw the Citadel. Was captured long before.
Interesting.
I was born.
How did your people wage war against the Reapers?
Attrition. We fought them system by system, planet by planet, city by city. Entire worlds were sacrificed just to slow the Reapers down. Time they spent harvesting a population was time we could regroup.
That must have cost you in the long run.
Yes. Our own people would be indoctrinated. converted, then turned against us. But there was no choice. Mercy is not a weapon. It is a weakness.
Why do you think your own cycle lost the war?
What had been our strength, our empire, became a liability. All races conformed to one doctrine, one strategy. The Reapers exploited this. Once they found our weaknesses, we could not adapt.
Groupthink.
The subservient races became divided and confused. Then, it was only a matter of time.
I'm happy to say our cycle is different. Most races cooperate, but they still remain unique.
Then it may be your only hope.
Alright, so it's just the Reapers, station, sentry ability. Have we been asked about civilization yet? We have those two. Other device.
Is there anything more you can tell us about this device your people were trying to build?
We heard only stories. They said our scientists were constructing a great machine that had the power to defeat the Reapers.
You never saw it?
By that point, the Empire was smashed into pieces. None of us knew what the others were doing.
Well, if we don't finish it soon, the same will be true of us.
Back on Eden Prime, it looked like there were other stasis pods. What happened?
The Empire had fallen, and we knew our cycle was lost. We were the final vanguard, the best soldiers left alive.
So more of you were supposed to survive into this cycle?
Yes. Under my leadership, a new Prothean Empire would have arisen. We would have commanded the races of your time to prepare for the next Reaper invasion. But traitors within our ranks, indoctrinated agents, betrayed us, and the Reapers discovered our plan.
Just out of curiosity, how would you have commanded us?
By leaving you no other option. You would have joined our army, or faced the Reapers alone.
We've uncovered quite a few Prothean ruins. Were you observing our ancestors?
Before the war, we cultivated species who showed potential. Eventually, you would have been offered a choice to join
the Empire. Fine choice.
But when the Reapers attacked, we ceased all study. We hoped they would see you as too primitive to harvest.
Well, thank you, I think.
Okay.
Liara here would never forgive me if I didn't ask you. What was Prothean civilization like?
Yes, I've always wondered. What sort of government did you have? Can you tell me about your religious beliefs, or perhaps the...
We are dead now. What does it matter?
I'm sorry. Studying your history has been a lifelong passion of mine.
When I was born, our empire was already at war with the Reapers. The first thing I remember was seeing my planet on fire.
What was your civilization like before the Reaper attack?
We were the dominant race of our cycle. We ruled the galaxy.
My studies indicated you were the only race engaged in space travel at the time. I always found that curious.
We were one empire composed of many subjects. All eventually called themselves Prothean.
What if they didn't want to?
They weren't given a choice.
Are you saying you enslaved the other species?
Any could oppose us if they wished. And if they had won, they would have ruled. Many tried. None succeeded.
I had no idea Protheans were so severe.
It was by necessity. Very early, we encountered the dangers posed by machine intelligence. They rebelled against us.
We've had the same problem. They're called Geth.
We could not allow the machines to surpass us. It was decided the only way to win was to unite all organic life within our empire.
Did it work?
For a time. The Metacon War. We were turning the tide. Until the Reapers arrived. Then we understood machines had surpassed us long ago, in ways we could never imagine.
Thank you for talking with me. I never imagined actually meeting a Prothean.
This has been
interesting
amusing.
Oh?
To discover the most primitive races of my time now rule the galaxy. The Asari, the humans, the Turians.
There's also the Salarians.
The lizard people evolved?
I believe they're amphibian.
They used to eat flies. Commander, you may count on me. I am known as Javik, though I still need time to recover. The shock has not worn off yet.
I understand. This must be a hell of an experience for you. We're just glad to have you aboard, Javik.
All right. New gun. Next time we will check out the new state of the universe with our after this mission and see what else is going on. See you then.